dintre una stanzulella fredda e scura, ad una volta in sotterra se sola, mostro sulla tenga.
Basic things that make wonderful cooking. I have dedicated these films to my grandchildren and to my stepdaughters. They are now away, many of you, and are beginning life where you need to be cooking for yourself, and I think it's very important that you start with good food. Carbonara is a dish that is well known in Italy. It is usually referred as spaghetti alla carbonara, and is a dish that was created during the revolutionary time of Italy in the mid-1800s, where the revolutionary guys were hiding in coal mines. We call it carbone, it means coal. And so they were these fellows that had to have one dish that would last all day long. And they made this carbonara. This is the way that it looks. If you could see it, it's a very full dish that young people love. Particularly my grandchildren and my stepdaughters love this dish, so I'm dedicating it to them specially. Before we go any further, let me tell you a little bit about the dishes that I use. Carbonara is fantastic because you make different things and then you put them all together in small squares. It is best thing to cut bacon. It's easier if it is a little cool. Sometimes I put it in the freezer for a few minutes just before cutting. The pan is at medium fire, no? So be patient. This is maybe the thing that takes most with cooking carbonara. Cook slowly and kind of touch it once in a while. If you don't check the bacon, it's burnt, so keep an eye on it without doing too much. One of my great things that I learned cooking is to cook in a way that is not going to be very messy. Remember, if you cook in a smart way, you do not have too many balls to clean and too many things. So then you're whisking a little bit the eggs, doesn't take very much. And now the eggs are whisked. And I will add the cheeses, the Parmesan cheese first. It doesn't matter if it is first the Romano cheese. Don't get yourself completely torn up and all this thing is done, because if we are on television, otherwise it will be so much easier whenever you do it at home. And then you have the Romano cheese, and voila, it's done. The only way that I know to do is that if you put the knife like this and then gently punch the garlic so that it breaks a little bit, then it is very, very easy to peel. Otherwise, it's really difficult. Now, you see the peel comes out by itself. Voila, a piece of garlic already clean. And now we're going to the red pepper. The red peppers, I may have told you before, but you buy them from a store, and then you take the head out of the red pepper and take the inside out of the red pepper. Those little, whatever you call them, they are very, very full of pepper, so just keep them away. And by the way, make sure that you wash very well your hands after having handled the red peppers, because if you start scratching your nose or your eyes, can burn very badly. The bacon is almost done. The juice that has come out of the bacon, there it is, and there it goes. And now the same pan where the bacon has been cooked, what you do, you put a little olive oil, and voila, a little olive oil, and the garlic, and the red peppers. you have to be very careful when you do this, that the garlic doesn't burn, because if it burns, completely becomes very, the oil becomes very bitter. It's very, very important, as I mentioned to you before, that to cook pasta you have a lot of water. It's also very important that water be very, very boiling very strongly. Then at this point you add the salt. I like coarse sea salt. And I like to keep it close to where I'm cooking because I use it all the time. There is more salt than you realize because there is a lot of water. So don't feel shy about putting salt in the water. And then you put the pasta. Notice that the water is boiling now even stronger because of the salt. I'm increasing the temperature of the water. 7 minutes. You put the timer on, and now the water is boiling. You stir once in a while. Keep it covered. Make sure that the pot keeps on boiling all the time. And meanwhile, not immediately. It takes a little bit long. And it's not ready yet. By having the pan with the olive oil, if you remember, and with marinated garlics and pepper, you keep this pot warm, butter in the pan with olive oil, and make it warm. This pan has to be with warm oils. I call it the oil stand. This is a fantastic spoon that my son Peter made for me, and it's the most beautiful spoon in the world. Now we are going to make the miracle of the carbonara. Remember what I told you before. In this pan, there is olive oil that has been marinated with the garlic and red pepper. The garlic and red pepper have been thrown away unless my grandson Joy is around, and then I save them because Joy likes the garlic. And this is getting warm right now because it has to be fairly warm. Not hot, but it has to be warm. Now in this pot here, we have the eggs, the whipped cream, and the cheese that have been prepared. That's it. Nothing magic, and this is the base. Voila! Now we are ready to make the fantastic magic of the carbonara. It's going to take another couple of minutes, so you can... When you drain the pasta, make sure that you leave a little bit of water at the bottom, and then replace the pasta back very quickly in the pot. Put it back on the fire, but this time the fire should be very low, very low. Remember, it's extremely important. Now you have the oil pan that goes in first. So what are you doing right now is you're adding warm oils and a little butter in the pasta. Now, notice what I am stirring. This, you can turn it off and move it away. I'm stirring the pan with the pasta, and there is a little fire going on. And now I will add the cheese. I will add the cheese. And the cream and the eggs. Voila! And now I am going to take a little bit easy, and I'm going to be waiting for the eggs to cook. And you have to be very careful not to make scrambled eggs, because if you cook them too much, then they become scrambled eggs. But now the cream of the carbonara is being made. as you can see. And, porca miseria, this thing looks pretty good now. It begins to smell fantastic. And now we are going to add the bacon. Voila! The bacon is added. And now we have the carbonara is almost ready. Oh, give me a plate and I will put some carbonara in a plate to be ready to eat. See, I keep stirring the carbonara, turn off so there's no more fire. The pasta is ready. And you serve the carbonara and voila, I hope you like it. La